Julian, welcome to Swansea. How does it feel to be here?
Really good. Really settled in pretty quickly, to be honest. I've been to a couple of the games, Preston away, Birmingham at home. Got myself into a flat on Sunday, and then first day yesterday. Feels like I've been here a lot longer than 2 days, to be honest.
What are your aims and hopes as you come into this important role at the club?
Yeah, so early, difficult to sort of say, isn't it? But I think the club has a really good platform, despite the challenges of, you know, coming out of the Premier League a couple of years ago. Great facilities, great people here, great identity as a football club, the way they play. Steve obviously picking up on that now with the style of play is the right thing. The club is, you know, a genuinely good football club, good facilities, and should be a really competitive, you know, team in the Championship, aspiring to be in the Premier League, dare I say.
Yeah.
But that's a fact. You know, every club in the Championship has to have that aspiration. You know, you're here to compete and you're here to play. You're doing the best with what you have. So this club is no different to a lot of others.
Yeah, Swansea got to the playoffs last year. They went close.
Yeah.
Having said that, everybody knows that the finances of the club, you know, they're not going to be throwing money at the team to try to succeed. Do you think the Premier League is a realistic ambition in the short term?
Yeah, look, I've worked at football clubs where there's been a similar challenge. So the budget is the budget. I've just come from a football club that had one of the lowest budgets in the Championship and got promoted to the Premier League. Okay, a lot of things were aligned. A lot of things came together in a moment. I could bore you to death with all of that, but you know, it's not undoable. But you have to appreciate how competitive financially this division is. But in a way, not get too concerned by what others do. You have to have a belief in what you do. Across the football club, you know, we're here to put a football team on the field the best we can with the resources that we have. And in doing that, you engender a sense of belief in what you do, right? So you don't keep up with the Joneses because it's a ridiculous route to take. Stick to your own plan, have a belief in what you do, develop players, you know, attract good players. The facilities do that, the coach does that, the club itself in terms of its history and identity and its story does that. The place actually in Swansea is absolutely an amazing place to be. So it's about doing the best we can do within a framework and not worrying too much about what some of the competitors do, because we know that's been the road to financial ruin for many.
The manager who got Swansea up the one time in the past to the Premier League, Brendan Rodgers, someone you know well. Have you spoken to him about coming to the club?
Yes, indeed. Actually, when I was interviewed for this job, it was a fairly sort of protracted process. I think they were interviewing a number of candidates. And as part of that process, the guys asked if they could speak to some of my business associates, people who I'd done business with, so maybe a lawyer or an architect or something. Not my actual references. So they had my references. These were sort of more relationship things. And then also asked to speak to the managers that I'd worked with. So I gave them three. So Brendan was one. Brendan was actually, as a CEO, my first head coach, and I was his first CEO, I think. So, we've kept in touch. He's had an amazing career, to be honest. But when I first met him, you know, he was tremendously young, brilliant coach, which he's proven out through his career. And I asked him if he'd speak to the guys on my behalf, and he did. So he helped me in a way to secure this job, as did the other guys. David Wagner did a similar thing for me from a Huddersfield point of view. So it was a very sort of thorough process of coming here, being interviewed, and them talking to lots of people that have worked with me in the past. Brendan sent me a nice message, did a nice article actually for the website with the guys, which I didn't know about, which is great. You know, he didn't need to do that, but he did. So that's a measure of the guy, isn't it?
Did you give him his job then? At Watford?
No. So I took over as CEO in December of 2008, I think it was. And just prior to that, Eddie Boothroyd had left in the November, and Brendan had been appointed through... I was part of the process, but I didn't appoint him. So I was deputy CEO at the time. And then there was an EGM, and lots of people left, and I became CEO. So quickly I was, within a month, you know, I was sort of his CEO, effectively.
And you told us about the interview process for you to get this role. Yeah. Was it something you applied for, or did the Swansea's owners come to you? How did it work?
So I should say, I've known Steve and Jason and Sam Porter for before the period that they bought Swansea. So I was in between work, I think when I left Sheffield United, and I was introduced to them by a mutual colleague. So I knew of them at that point. Since then, obviously, I've gone off and done other things. We've had a interim dialogue when Huddersfield and Swansea were in the Premier League together. Obviously, we saw each other at shareholders' meetings and touched base again, and that was very nice. Sam, I've spoken to on and off about industry-related things, you know, how's life at Swansea, how's life at Huddersfield, and so kept an open dialogue with that. But no, they rang me, basically, to see what my situation was. Made it clear they were interviewing others, but that's fine. And then it went from there, really.
You probably know them better than most people in Swansea then, in that case, because we haven't seen a lot of them in recent times in this part of the world. I mean, what do you make
when
of them?
When you say know them.
Attitude to football and to Swansea City, obviously, in particular.
Yeah, I mean, when I met them originally, they were looking at, you know, investing in a UK football club. So I understood where they were going with it. I was never around at the time when they decided to buy Swansea. But, you know, the idea of investors acquiring football clubs and taking football clubs forward, you know, different people have different approaches. So their approach is clear to everyone. You know, they want the club to be sustainable. They want the club to be successful, right? They're not doing anything to make it unsuccessful. They're doing everything they can to make it successful. But they want it to be sustainable. And we look across lots and lots of different divisions where clubs get into difficulty by overcooking their expectations and therefore the resources required to take a club forward. You know, I think they will continue to be very supportive of this club. I think they'll be very supportive of me, hopefully, doing this job. They've obviously made the decision, so that's good. But, you know, it'll be clear about the framework within which we operate. You know, we're not going to operate outside of a clear understanding of what the resources are. And then it comes down to resource allocation. It comes down to people. It comes down to the people that are within the organisation to build a feeling and a dynamic that takes the club forward another step. Trevor's been in for a period of time. I know Trevor quite well. I've spoken to him about his time here. He was very complimentary. But, you know, I can't do too much reflecting on the past, and I won't. I'll take it from yesterday and today and deal with what's in front of us. And my approach is, you know, the people are the key to what take a club forward. You know, it's difficult at the moment, tremendously difficult, because of the lack of engagement with fans. That is a really difficult thing. And I've been out of football since, so I gave notice at Huddersfield in September. I worked up to Christmas, and then I was on garden leave to the end of March. So my last football match was pre-Christmas. So I've missed all this sort of COVID challenge. And coming into a football club yesterday for the first time with COVID implications was really quite strange. The matches that I've been to, the two matches, they're really different, and it's really peculiar that, in essence, all of what we do is to put a team on the field for fans to engage with and enjoy, and collectively enjoy the entertainment and the success, winning. There's nothing like winning. There's nothing like getting promoted. There's nothing like, you know, enjoying that feeling of a match day and the final whistle going and the fans, you know, that thing is a really massive miss for everyone, I think, at a football club. So the dynamics that we have to create are providing different ways of engaging with fans as best we can. So it's got a bit of a challenge on here about how we do that. And we've been talking about this for a couple of days. You know, how do we do that? How do we best engage our fans in what we're trying to achieve? And we've got to get creative. And let's see how we do. But there is this internal dynamic thing of people just feeling good about the place and good about what we do, and they're tremendously proud, the people here, of working for Swansea, which is a brilliant thing. And hopefully we just take that forward.
Just going back to the owners, from the talks you've had with them, are they here for the long term, do you think? Are they talking long term with you?
Yeah, never given me any indication that they're not. So they own the football club. I don't think there's any intention not to. So, yeah, very clear. Get in and get on with the job.
And their aim is to get back to the Premier League?
Like everyone in the Championship. You know, I can't see that being different. We haven't had that specific discussion yet, but you're in a competition to win the competition or to get into the places that take you to the next level. Everyone in the Championship has got to be competing for that.
Trevor Birch, I mean, I say your predecessor, he was chairman, your chief exec, but I think it's similar. Well, you're going to have similar roles. He told us that he was basically given full control of the club on a day-to-day basis. He was in charge. He ran the show. Is it going to be the same with you?
Yeah, I believe so. So I think what I would add to that is, even if you're a CEO, chairman in control of a football club, the job of the CEO is to create that framework that exists around what the finances are, what the resource allocation is going to look like. And if you're operating to a plan, which we will have a plan, then open dialogue with shareholders is normal. So I've spoken to most or all of the shareholders and board members as part of the process of being interviewed and then subsequently since I've got the job. So if you're ever outside of what you perceive to be your plan, so if you're outside of scope, clearly, you need to go and have open dialogue with your shareholders about what that means. If you're inside the scope, then I think you get on and manage on a daily basis and weekly and monthly basis. But regular open dialogue with shareholders, directors, is key for me to ensure we stay on the plan. And then if we're ever outside of it, everybody knows about it. And we've got ideas about how we solve problems.
Just a couple more from me. How much is your role about the football side of the club? Is it, have you got full control of that or not? How will that work?
So as a CEO of a football club, you cannot leave football out of your scope of control. You know, most of our resources go on the football world, putting matches on, paying players, looking after training grounds, all the resource allocation that we do. And everybody that works here fundamentally helps to put a team on the field that we all enjoy, right? So if you're a CEO of a football club and not having oversight of that area, well, that's a nonsense. That's not a CEO. I am a CEO in charge of the club. So I have oversight of the whole club.
So transfers, for example, which we all like to talk about all the time.
Yeah.
You'll be talking to Steve Cooper and,
of course,
and the recruitment team about that.
Yeah, of course, on a regular basis. So I intend to split my time between stadium, training ground, and academy. So I haven't yet worked out the proportions of time spent in each area, but to have regular meetings, regular dialogue with key staff, on site, in their site, here, wherever that might be. It's a multi-site operation, and as CEO, you've got to be in charge of it all. There's no part of it that you can't be accountable to, because there's one thing for sure: if there's a problem, and the shareholders want an answer to it, and I can't give it, and that's going to look extraordinary, isn't it? So I'll be in charge of the club. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.